The strategies that would help to reduce healthcare disparities, I think we can think about in several categories of short-term, medium-term, and long-term. I think in the short-term, we have to make sure that we have access to care. So, for example, many states have not expanded Medicaid under the Affordable Care Act. Those states are leaving money on the table that would immediately expand access to care. I grew up in the state of Alabama. It's a rural state. Rural hospitals are closing because they're underfunded, and expansion of Medicaid would provide immediate relief for hundreds of thousands of individuals who are lacking access to health care. So I think that's something that could be done, you know, very quickly if state legislatures were willing to act. Secondly, in the medium term, I think we need to build our healthcare infrastructure, particularly our public health infrastructure. We began to realize, I think, during the COVID pandemic, how critical public health infrastructure is. I think many of us, including those of us in healthcare, underappreciate the importance of having a public health infrastructure. But we've seen it with COVID, we've seen it with monkeypox, the ability to do contact tracing and to educate and to vaccinate quickly are really critical. And so we have to make sure that we are investing in our public health infrastructure and in our public health workforce. Over the long term, we have to address the major structural barriers to healthcare and that facilitate healthcare disparities. And these are the hard ones: income inequality, lack of access to jobs in certain communities, poor education. Education has long been the central driver of an opportunity to move from one rung of the socioeconomic ladder to another. But when our public education system is failing, that ladder is pulled out from those individuals. So those structural elements of income inequality and education have to be addressed if we're really ever going to make a dent in closing the gap in long-term outcomes in terms of healthcare and, you know, really improving overall survival and closing the gaps between what we see between black men who have the lowest life expectancy and white women who have the highest life expectancy in the United States.